Yo, what's up, guys? Chili Moose back again. First of all, a big thank you to you guys for your patience. I know it's been a while since I've posted about the KTM. A lot going on over here within the past year. I think actually I haven't even posted it's been like a little over a year. But either way, here we are. So, new house, new job. But it's been a year here in the new house, and I'm back on it. So thank you guys. Big, huge shout out to Raul Alonso 44. Pecky Code. And my man Cheech Z. What up, Cheech? All right, guys. So, ain't nothing to it but to do it. I didn't come here to talk. I came here to show you. So let's get into it.
Thank you.
So first off, the cleaning of the swing arm came out really nice. I'm very happy with it. Also the rear shock, I cleaned this guy up a little bit. It's looking nice and purdy. This is what I used, Simple Green Max. And that was it, Simple Green, some water, a brush. I just picked this up. Just got back from the store. I picked this up. Maxima waterproof grease. And let me show you. Here we have this guy right here. So here it is. This is the swing arm bearings. It's gonna go here. That's the part number for you guys. Made in Taiwan. And it is, there's the part number there, 28-1125. So this is all balls, swing arm bearings kit. One color, one size, fitment 52. And this is all the parts in there. So now, so I don't have the Tusk tool for the swing arm bearings, but like I said, this is a budget build, budget without really, you know, spending too much money and getting all those proper tools. But I'm going to show you how I do it. If you have the money for the tools, I suggest you go and get it, because I waste a lot of time trying to find the right tool or something that we can use without damaging these bearings. So like I said, I'll show you what I got, show you how I do it, and you guys let me know in the comments. Let me know if you guys have any other ideas or techniques that we can use. All right. not good. Here we go. Okay. Here we go. So now I got this little guy. Socket. So let me show you what we have in there. Get a close up in there. So that's the bearing. That's the bearing right there. And you have a little, the lip, this lip here is part of the swing arm. So you don't want to damage that. You want to get a socket that's just gonna ride this bearing, and you want the same diameter as the bearing so that you could push it out. Now again, Tusk makes a tool for this. I don't have that kind of money. I'm hoping I don't damage this swing arm, but let's see how we do. We're looking at 3.003. So I'll find a socket that'll give me that. This guy that I have here is a little smaller. But I'll find a socket that's, this actually might work because I don't want it to bite into the frame. So let's see if this will work. Thank you. All right, so it's working, but I need another one of these, a little bigger, because the bearings have pushed through, but it's hitting this guy. So let me find another socket. All right, here we go, guys. This one will work. There you go. Okay. So that's one of the bearings. There's actually two bearings in there, so gotta grab the other guy. Let me grab a longer socket. All right, so this is a 3/4 inch. This is slightly smaller diameter than this 13/16, but it'll work. All right, guys, that did not work. Oh, actually, it did work. Yeah, there you go. So I got that guy out. Let me show you what it looks like inside. Okay, so we got both bearings out. I'm gonna clean this up. Hopefully I didn't damage the swing arm. I don't think I did, because everything kind of came out pretty smoothly. But here we got the two bearings. I'll stack them up. Two bearings. This guy, actually, this goes like this. Let me back up a little bit. Actually, this goes like this. That goes like that inside. And then you have, these are the seals. So that's how the assembly goes inside of the swing arm. All right, so I'm gonna do the other side. I'll clean this up and then I'll show you guys what we're working with.
Whew. All right, guys, update. So second bearing gave me a little trouble, but I just took my time. you know, like I said, you don't want to damage this aluminum swing arm. So just take your time, nice and easy. It'll get done. And again, we're on a budget. So I cleaned it up. Let me show you what it looks like. All right, so here we go. Nice and clean. Ready for the new bearings. And I also looked inside there, made sure I didn't damage anything. Here's the other one. That looks pretty good. Okay. All right, so let's see what we got in this package here. Oh, nice. Nice little sticker. Okay. We got the seals. Other seals. So here are the bearings. I don't know what these guys are called. And then we got the two inner assemblies. So here we go. That's what we're working with. Again, here's the part number. All right, guys, the video is getting a little too long, so don't forget to hit that subscribe button, and I'll post the next video soon.